in our way to attain Allah Ta'ala's nearness. And everyone will lower his head that please do some dua for me, or pay some focus on me, pay some attention to me so that my shop can run and people can run after me and I can do dhikr. This desire has finished, that I want to attain Allah Ta'ala's nearness. This desire and passion is finished. Just people, I want them to sit with me and I will host dhikr, and I'm inside, I am just nothing myself. This is ajeeb, weird, you can say, form of tasawwuf that has overwhelmed the generation today, in this day and age. And we need to struggle and strive more, because this door will not close. Until Qiyamah it will continue. Rather, the reality is this, that just like the hadith states, that as long as there's somebody who says Allah, who remembers Allah, not me and you, the one who truly recites the name of Allah, remembers Allah, until that day Qiyamah will not come, the day of judgment will not come. So it's true, it's there, that as long as there's a wali of Allah, a friend of Allah, a person who's connected to Allah, who says Allah's name, recites Allah's name sincerely, properly, then Qiyamah will not come. So this door will not close. So we can't do mujahidah. And the door itself cannot shut. The path cannot be terminated. We say, no, I want to do mujahidah as well. I want to make effort. So here, for this person also, Rasulullah in this prescription is giving the solution. Even if you get 1 hour before you die, and you have yaqeen on this hadith, then start this deed, and you will also be successful. Allah's Rasul said, okay, fine, your life's passed, time has been wasted. But if you accept this statement of Rasulullah, then you can also become a wali of Allah. So this is mercy, we should not delay. Don't waste time. So this is one amal that the Sahabi requested, that Rasulullah ﷺ prescribed such an amal that will give ease in its implementation and the greatest and the most reward. So Rasulullah ﷺ said, you're asking such a deed in which all of the rewards you will attain, and you'll attain Allah's nearness and all the thawab that I've mentioned before, and then you don't need to do mujahada anymore and you can carry on easily in your life. Okay, fine, listen, Rasulullah ﷺ gave the answer. Subhanallah, Rasulullah ﷺ gave the pure and clean and easy solution. What a great amal. This is Sahih Tirmidhi and Muslim. This hadith is included. It's not a small hadith. Sahih Tirmidhi and Sahih Muslim. Allah's Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, okay, my companion, I will tell you such a prescription. لا يزال لسان رطبا من ذكر الله. That you ask me for a deed that's easy and you'll attain Allah's nearness. That if you do this deed and grab hold of this deed, and you're regular in it, and robustly you grab hold of this deed and you implement it properly with the adab, with the regularity, and you do amal on this, you practice on this, Allah's Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that all of them, the mujahidat you have done, you have set forth on the journey to Allah's nearness, and if you're regular on this, then you will rise as the wali of Allah in the hereafter. And what is that? لا يزال لسان رطبا بذكر الله. That your tongue, MashaAllah, all of us have a tongue. We're all being given this advice by Rasulullah SAW, that your tongue, this is being told to the Sahabi, but in reality to all of us, your tongue should be what? Always should be moist and regular and busy in doing the dhikr of Allah. Your tongue, with the dhikr of Allah. It should be moist and regular and busy, occupied in the dhikr of Allah. Rasulullah said, you do dhikr of Allah and I give you the guarantee that you will rise in the hereafter on a very high platform and level. So this is the dhikr of Allah, my brothers, my friends. The walis of Allah have grabbed hold of this. End of story. Whoever you will see, the person who is the wali of Allah, the person who does dhikr of Allah, they grabbed hold of this rope of Allah with strength and firmly, end of story. So now if we grab hold of this practice, action of dhikr of Allah, and if a person does this with adab, with their manners, with the desire, with passion, and with one objective, I want to get close to Allah. There's a hunger, there's a thirst, something should come, I need liquid or water so my tongue, because it's dry at the moment. And when the tongue is moist, then do you have a need for something at that time? You don't have any need for anything. Then do you need water? No, I'm not thirsty. I don't need water. Isn't it? This is the situation. So if it's dry, you need water. I'm thirsty. I need to quench my thirst. So here, ratban lisan. That here, the hint or the direction that comes out from the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam statement is that when a person does dhikr of Allah, and his tongue will become what? It will become moist and fresh with due to dhikr of Allah. In other words, that due to the dhikr of Allah, after doing dhikr of Allah, a person will not need anything after that. He will have not a desire for anything. He will be fresh and moist, and every deed will come to him in his life. Every amal, he will attain the noor and the taste of all the deeds. Just like the person who has had a dry tongue, and he drinks water, and it's moist, and he has no need for anything after that. He has no desire. And his tongue is then moist, and he has no need to ask or run after something, or think about something else. He has no need. The tongue is moist, then his ruh is moist. And then due to the dhikr he's doing, all of his requirements of life are fulfilled. So dhikr of Allah is a beautiful, beautiful action. May Allah Ta'ala give us tawfiq. We do it, we try. The brothers, the individuals who don't do dhikr, who have a desire, they want to get close to Allah, then very easy. Meet a wali of Allah, present your situation, your circumstances. I do this work, I'm in the dunya like this. I've got 6 or 7 businesses. I go 8 a.m, I come 5 p.m. Then I have to look after my children, I'm busy, dunya. I've got a very stretched lifestyle.